Hello, this video is a little different than normal. As you know, I play a lot of music, mostly Greek, but I make also a lot of music software. And recently I have made Transpose, which you can use online for free. I know that a lot of my subscribers are musicians, so I thought it would be nice to tell you more about Transpose. Of course you can find many transposes on the internet, but the one that I made is very advanced and you can not only transpose but you can also convert between many different formats including Greek, as you can see here. To be able to use Transpose, JavaScript has to be enabled in your browser. Let's see what you can do with Transpose. First, you need lyrics, including chords. I like the site Kithara. Now let's transpose the song Rosa. I will only copy a part of it so that you can see more clear what Transpose is doing. I paste it in the upper area. And now it's important that the input format matches with the format that you have pasted. Okay, this is the CDE format, so that is good. And as output, I want for now also CDE. Now we can transpose the song by setting the number of semitones that we want to transpose up or down. So negative is down. So yeah, you can transpose it 2 semitones down like this and then press the transpose button. And then you can see here the result. If you want to transpose differently, you can simply select another number of semitones and click the transpose button again. Or you can click the up-down buttons. As you can see, transpose tries always to keep the original chord positions, which is of course very important. Now let's see some different output formats. Inline is not that easy to read for people, but it is very easy for computers to read. And therefore it is often used to exchange between different programs. Do, Re, Mi is also often used in Greece. I have made also a Greek version of it. And as you can see, now there are Greek characters. And the minor chords are indicated with a minus. And the major chords are indicated with a plus, which is very common in Greek music. But if you prefer not to have the plus, you can enable compact. And then it leaves it out. Then we have also the Roman format, Roman numerals. And for this you need to set the key of the original input, so in this case that is F minor, and then when we transpose we see here the Roman notation, and the transpose has of course no influence on this notation, And this is the same for the Nashville notation. Now, of course, the most important, how can you use the result? You can very fast print it by clicking the print button. This way you can also save it to a PDF file. But what I mostly do is I select the result by pressing the select all button, and then I press Ctrl C to copy it, and I paste it in a new document so that I can make the layout the way I want. Let's see some more of the options. If you prefer the chords not to be bold, you can disable this option. If you prefer sharps instead of flats, then you can use this option. So here you see the B flat, and then it will be A sharp. Here you can see that there is no space between the chords. And in the result we see that the position is the same as in the original, but when we transpose it a little, like this, now we can see that the positions are not the same. And this is because of this option, space between chords. With this option you make sure that there is always at least one space between the chords, which makes it more readable. But if you find it more important that the position is at the exact place where the chord is changing, then it's better if you switch this off. If you prefer real musical symbols, you can enable special charge. And now you see that the sharp looks different, and also the flat looks different. Keep in mind that not all programs can understand these special charge. Now let's see another option. If we have the Do Re Mi format, in some countries they don't say C, but they say T. So for this you can enable use T, and then instead of this C flat, you see T flat. If you want to know more about one of the options, you can press the help button. And here you can see everything described. And of course, when you have a question or feedback, you can always email me. With the inline format, mostly there are square brackets used, but in case you need a different bracket, you can choose it here. So let's change the output to round brackets. So this is for the input and this is for the output. So, and now as you can see, it has changed it to round brackets. And let's copy this now to the input. So, for example, we have this as an input, and then we set the input format to in line, and let's say that we want to convert this to the normal CDE format. Now when we press it, it doesn't change anything because it cannot understand it. And that is because in the format there are round brackets used, but we have set here the input to be square brackets. So now if we set it to round brackets, now you see that it understands it. It can be that lines with unusual chords are not transposed or converted. In that case, you can disable the strict option and try it again. You can also display the notes in uppercase, for example, with the Greek output format. Like this. There is also an option lowercase is minor, which you need to use when in the input format a lowercase character indicates a minor chord. So I hope that transpose is useful for you. I will put a link in the description. Thank you for watching. Yassas.